It's Friday, 24th August, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. The Kerala government yesterday claimed in the Supreme Court that the sudden release of water from the Mullaperiyar dam was the cause for the floods in the state. In an affidavit, Kerala slammed Tamil Nadu for allegedly ignoring its repeated entreaties for the controlled release of water from the reservoir to facilitate the evacuations of thousands living downstream. Kerala said that a supervisory committee headed by the chairman, Central Water Commission or CWC, and secretaries of both states as members should be formed with authority to take decisions by majority opinion regarding operations during floods or similar calamities. Further, a management committee reporting directly to the supervisory committee should be formed to manage the day-to-day operations of the Mullaperiyar Dam. This committee should be headed by a chief engineer or superintending engineer of the CWC, with both chief engineers / superintending engineers of the two states, Mr. Jose proposed. The affidavit was filed in response to a petition filed by Idli resident Russell Joy, highlighting the perils of a dangerously high water level in the British Era Dam, made worse by the utter lack of coordination between the two state governments and a non-existent disaster management plan. Finding the efforts by internet giants to curb circulation of online videos of sexual violence against women and children inadequate, the government is likely to seek stricter directions to service providers such as Facebook and YouTube from the Supreme Court. The directions sought will include considerably reducing the time taken by the intermediary to comply with content removal requests under certain sections of the IT Act to less than 10 hours from about 36 hours at present, an official source said. Additionally, the government is also keen on intermediaries sharing certain data with law enforcement agencies to identify the origin of such content. The issue of tracing the origin of unlawful content is already a bone of contention between the government and WhatsApp, which was recently pulled up by the centre after being misused to spread fake news. Intermediaries should be asked to keep a complete trail of forwarding of unlawful content and verify and maintain identifiers of the users that can help attribute information to the users, the source added. Currently, on the issue of assistance to law enforcement agencies on identification of offender, the response is often delayed and the metadata of end-to-end communication is not provided. They need to ensure 100% compliance as far as requests from law enforcement agencies are concerned. India bagged two bronze medals in rowing through Rohit Kumar and Bhagwan Singh in lightweight double sculls after Dushyant started the day with a third place finish in lightweight single sculls at the Asian Games in Palembang. Indian rowers Rohit and Bhagwan clocked 7:04.61 to win bronze in their event at the JSC Lake. Earlier, Dushyant had won the country its first rowing medal at the ongoing games, claiming a bronze in men's lightweight single sculls. Dushyant, who was declared the best rower in the 2013 National Championships, finished third on the podium with a timing of 7:18.76 as India enjoyed a good beginning on the sixth day of competition. The Indian, who began rowing in 2012 at an army training camp in Roorkee, had won a bronze in the last edition of the Games too, in Incheon. This was India's 20th medal at the ongoing Games and 12th bronze. The country has also won 4 gold and as many silver medals. The humble stone-based Idli grinder is enabling a global bean-to-bar fine chocolate movement. In 2004, John Nancy, founder of US-based Chocolate Alchemy, spotted a photo of an old-style melange and noticed the resemblance to the way more affordable Indian wet grinders. This, in many ways, meant the start of the global bean-to-bar fine chocolate movement. In 2011, within a week of discovering that stone grinders can be used to make fine chocolate, Vincent Mauroux, a luxury chocolate maker in Vietnam, traveled with his business partner to source a small Indian-made premier stone grinder from Little India in Singapore. The advantages of the Indian stone grinders are that you can achieve great results simply, immediately, and inexpensively. They are also easy to use and maintain, says Vincent. The Indian stone grinder has also been credited with the shift towards fine chocolates from traditionally large chocolate-making countries like Belgium to cacao-producing countries like Ecuador and Peru, where fine chocolate culture did not exist previously. Treasurer Scott Morrison will be Australia's new Prime Minister after winning a three-way battle for the leadership of the Liberal Party on Friday, with incumbent Malcolm Turnbull not contesting the party ballot. There were three contenders in the leadership vote: former Home Affairs Minister Peter Dutton, who narrowly lost a leadership vote against Turnbull on Tuesday, Mr. Morrison, and Foreign Minister Julie Bishop. The Liberal Party is the senior partner in the ruling Conservative coalition that will face an election by May 2019. The Liberal National Government has consistently trailed the opposition Labour Party in opinion polls. If Mr. Turnbull resigns from Parliament, he would leave the new government facing a by-election for his Sydney seat that could see it lose its one-seat majority. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 77.63 rupees per litre and diesel for 69.15 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 80.64 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.04 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 80.57 rupees per litre and diesel for 71.99 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 85.05 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.41 rupees per litre.